Americans burn more than 19 million barrels of oil a day, countless tons of coal and natural gas, too, raising persistent questions about supplies and the environmental impact. President Obama has pushed alternatives, solar power, electric cars, wind, and more. In fact, Mitt Romney says in a new policy paper, President Obama has intentionally sought to shut down oil, gas, and coal production in pursuit of his own alternative energy agenda. Romney wants more oil exploration, faster drilling permits, and state control of exploration on federal lands, an echo of the Republican chorus, drill, baby, drill.
I will set a national goal of America and North America, North American energy independence by 2020.
But President Obama says, chill, baby, chill.
Right now, under my administration, America is producing more oil today than at any time in the last 8 years. At any time.
So who is telling the truth? In the mid-1980s, U.S. crude oil production went into a decline, and yet despite a moratorium on offshore drilling after the Gulf spill, domestic production has surged, last year reaching its highest level since 2003. In addition, production from oil shale and natural gas is way up. However, much of this was set into motion years before President Obama took office. Technological advances by private firms have helped a lot, too. So while he has taken some steps to encourage production, he can't claim as much credit as he'd like to. For sure, the president has angered some oil and coal producers by pushing federal money toward alternative energy sources. But there's no evidence that he's tried to shut down the traditional energy industries. By the same token, it is not clear that Mitt Romney's plans would necessarily move the nation that much quicker toward energy independence without a simultaneous emphasis on reducing consumption.